31-31 series continues. Today we're talking about the Vancouver Canucks. Dan Rosen with Mike Johnson. And Mike, the Vancouver Canucks are sort of like, aren't they like that team that's stuck in the middle? Look, the last 4 years, go through the last 4 years offensively, they're the worst team in the NHL. Mm-hmm. 2.44 goals per game when you combine the last 4 years. Last season, a little bit better, 2.67, still tied for 25th with the New Jersey Devils. So you want to say improvement, fine, but right. I don't say that when you're tied for 25th. They were an 81-point team last year. They missed the playoffs by 9 points. Fourth straight season they missed. They've got good players, some, but they've mm-hmm. also, like I said,
they have enough of them.
They seem stuck in the middle. Do you agree?
Yes, and it wasn't because they're a team that realized. I felt like they realized when the Sedins retired. Okay, we're gonna have to bottom out a little bit. Yeah. We're gonna, you know, have a couple down years. We're gonna build around Besser and Pettersson and some of the guys we have.
Sure.
Plus Quinn Hughes. Plus other good players coming. And that seems like a good plan. I think that's the plan you have to do, whether you're Vancouver or New York or any team in the league. Mm-hmm. You know, you have to get a little worse, get some good draft picks,
sure,
and get better.
Yeah.
Feels like they tried to expedite their getting better. And they went out and got JT Miller, Michael Ferland, Tanner Pearson. They gave the big contracts to Beagle and Roussel,
Tyler Myers. 5-year deal.
And you're like, those are all NHL players. But on this roster, that many of them doesn't feel like they're a Stanley Cup contender. Maybe a playoff challenger,
mm-hmm.
but you don't want to build to be maybe a playoff challenger. So they are kind of stuck in the middle. I understand the business side. Got to sell tickets, yep. not our money. I understand GMs want to put a winner on the ice because that reflects well on them and their job security. But just as far as the direction of the organization, felt like they were still a year or two away from trying to add veterans like the way they did.
Sure.
Their team will be better. I don't think good enough.
No, well, that's the question. I mean, is the offense good enough? Look, Pettersson is terrific.
Yes.
I think we both agree. He had 66 points in 71 games last year. He plays a full season. He's a point per game player.
And the fact that he scored 28 last year,
yeah.
that's most surprising. Yeah. I thought if he got 65 points his rookie year, he would get 20 goals and 45 assists.
Where is more offense coming from? Last season, they had 5 players with 30 or more points.
Right.
That's it. They had 3 players with 50 or more points.
So you're counting on Pettersson.
Yeah.
You're counting on, obviously, Brock Besser. He had a pretty good year in what I think some people thought was a bit of a slower year for him. 56 and 69, 26 goals, yeah. injury plagued a little bit. Bo Horvat's a solid, consistent offensive contributor. So who else beyond those guys?
That's the question. Can JT Miller get you 60 points?
No. Not right? playing with Bo Horvat, he
can. Can he get you 50 points? He got 47 with Tampa last year.
Even though he played down a lot. He might get 50 yeah. okay. in today's day and age yeah. when he gets on the power play a lot. What's Tanner Pearson? What's Michael Ferland, who started out great last year, mm-hmm. but really struggled with health and production down the stretch? You know, Brandon Sutter's not that kind of player anymore. Right. Sven Barchi. They just have a lot of question marks, and they need almost all of them to hit. And they all won't. Yeah. Everyone's going to have a good year.
One thing they do have, they have Quinn Hughes.
Yes.
Who comes in, and he comes in with a lot of hype, but he played a little bit last year. He had 3 assists, 5 games,
he
averaged 18 minutes. He looked good in that small sample size. He really did. And I think this guy's going to come in. He should jump right into a top four role, maybe play with Tanev, maybe play with Myers, yeah. right? And this is a guy, like Pettersson last year, if you're a Vancouver Canucks fan, you get excited about mm-hmm. this guy. He could be really good defensively, too.
He really, defensively, but also
offensively. Well, on defense, yes, on defense. Yeah.
You know, because the confidence and creativity showed last year. Yeah. The willingness to make plays in his mm-hmm. very brief time with the Canucks out there. The 1-3-on-3 in overtime.
Yeah.
Him and Pettersson were playing, you know, keep away from everybody else.
They're a dangerous 3-on-3 team.
He had visions of the future yeah. dancing in yeah. that moment. So, yes, that's another great building block. And I think he'll be fine. And you're right. I think pairing him with Tanev or Myers, both are solid, stable veteran mm-hmm. defensemen, would be a nice fit for them. And another positive development last year, Jacob Markstrom
had a good year.
There have been yeah. question marks about him for almost a decade, yeah. really. And like, could he really ever be an above-average NHL starter? Last year, I think he was an above-average NHL starter. Yes. And if that can be one of the other things they pull out of last year and going forward, that they have now a starting goalie for the next 4 or 5 mm-hmm. years while Thatcher Demko gets himself situated,
yeah.
that's a positive.
I mean, he had a 2.77 and a 9.12 save,
yeah,
2.77 goals against, and a 9.12 save percentage. Those are decent numbers. Those are above average.
Above average.
Numbers for them. So are they a playoff team? They're one
yeah.
team here, of all the 31 that we've talked about, I don't know. Like, I mean, they have some good pieces.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's a division that is ripe for a team to jump ahead
That's
and
kicker,
go
right?
for it.
If you're counting on San Jose and Vegas,
Count on them.
Calgary, I guess, but I think there's some question marks that they could replicate last year.
But again, I mean,
is it a fourth spot coming out of the Pacific? You'd like to think they'll be battling Arizona and Edmonton, perhaps at LA and Anaheim further back. I have no. They're not going to make the playoffs. I think Travis Green gets them to play hard. I think they have a little bit more talent. I think Pedersen, Quinn Hughes will be fun. I think Bo Horvat, Brock Besser, good pieces. It's not quite enough.
I don't have them. I think they're a classic 85-point team.
Bubble team that's going to come on the wrong side of the bubble.
Just, you know why? A lot of middle six forwards and a lot of middle pair defenders. Yeah. They don't. Pedersen's a top player. I think there's no question. Besser could be, but there's just not enough there offensively for me. I think they have a good year. They battle and they get close. They're a classic 85-point just missed the playoff team.